Hello, my name is Jitka Všetečková and I'm Senior Lecturer in Health and Social Care in Faculty of Wellbeing, Education and Language Studies at the Open University. As part of the Aging Well mini-lectures, we are exploring how important it is over our lifespan to maintain a well-balanced nutrition and hydration, as well as regular physical and social activity in the older age. We explore how using this knowledge might facilitate self-management and delay the aging processes for as much as we can. As we know, we start aging the moment we're born. It demonstrates more significantly where we reach certain age, the usual benchmark being 65 plus. But our aging really starts much, much sooner. And the way aging demonstrates when we're over 65 depends a lot on decisions we've been making over our lifespan. Today, we'll focus on social stimulation. Linking cognitive and physical stimulation with social stimulation has been shown to be very effective in sharpening, protecting, and preserving our social, cognitive, and physical skills. Social stimulation enhances massively cognitive functions. If we want to stay in good physical and mental health for longer, we need to engage with things, places, people, the world around us, together with keeping an eye as well on nutrition, good hydration, physical and cognitive stimulation. As we grow older, it is very important to make time for activities we've always enjoyed in our lives. Continuing favorite activities can ensure the sustainability of cognitive stimulation and keep the practical functional benefits, skills and capacities we do not want to lose. Adding some new cognitive and social challenges is also great. Trying new activities enhances the brain plasticity greatly by requiring new learning or development of new cognitive strategies. Music lessons, learning new languages, new sports, aqua aerobics, dances bring about phenomenal cognitive stimulation, but also a social aspect of it. Meeting new people and keeping interest in people we have known for a long time is very important. And besides this being hugely cognitively stimulating, it is also a chance for us to get out on fresh air, meet someone over a coffee with plenty of water on the side. Please remember the importance of being well hydrated. Social engagement makes us feel alive, even if we do not necessarily agree with everyone we meet. They are massively brain stimulating and usually require us to go somewhere too, which brings about the physical activity. For example, enjoying a good meal in a company is a great and very stimulating too. If you like a challenge, you can engage in cognitively or socially challenging activities, generating so-called mental sweat. Things you've been doing forever and know inside out will not stimulate your brain so much anymore, so something new and challenging is a good alternative. Different types of cognitive and social activities have been for years now associated with preserving good cognitive skills and delaying the physical and cognitive decline usually associated with aging. Regular activities, both cognitive and physical, are necessary in preserving our brain and body functions. Meeting new people and keeping going sometimes because we have met interesting people that makes us feel emotion, laughter, sometimes anger, but foremost making us feel alive may be another reason why we will go on a walking tour with other people even if we don't feel up to it and would rather stay home just because it's cold and miserable outside. Whatever motivates you to go somewhere and do something, use it. Research has also shown that broader social networks and engagement with people have been associated with reduced Alzheimer's disease risk. So whatever it is that motivates you, the main thing is that you keep doing it. I hope these mini lectures were helpful and the useful tips might have helped you to enjoy your life fully and independently for longer. Don't forget that the GP is your good partner in keeping you in a good physical and mental health and well-being. But only you can make the decisions about what you're going to do, who you are going to meet, how much water you're going to drink today, and whether or not you will go out instead of staying home, and even worse, just stay sitting. By not going out, you are missing a lot what is happening, and some of it may even cheer you up. So on your way to pick up a glass of water, get your coat too, and on the way to enjoy the world, say also hi to your neighbor, and thanks for watching.
Get more from the Open University. Check out the links on screen now.